Hello, I'm Mother Winsome, and I'm the Reverend Mother of the Sisters of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We were founded in 2013, 11 sisters from the same community, the Anglican community of St. Mary the Virgin at Wantage, and one sister from another community. And together we founded the Sisters of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We were received into the church on the 1st of January 2013 into full communion of the Catholic Church, and we came in through the personal ordinariate of Our Lady of Walsingham. This was set up for groups of Anglicans to be received together, and it was the perfect vehicle for Anglican religious. We reaffirmed our vows as Catholics in the new community, but life as religious has been unbroken.
My name is Sister Barbara Clare, and when we became Catholics, it was a true homecoming for us, particularly in relation to the liturgy. We have formed our own divine office, drawing always on authorised sources, drawing together the liturgy of the Catholic Church, the monastic tradition, and the Coverdale version of the Psalms, set to the Sarum tones, and it's a way for us of reconnecting with pre-Reformation Catholicism, and we rejoice that we can have the privilege of bringing that into the church again, where it truly belongs.
My name is Sister Caroline Joseph. I was part of three sisters who came from a community that was based in Walsingham, and it was decided that we could join forces. Very similar charism, very similar background. Our original Victorian founders knew each other, and I was one of the ones that made that move and feel very at home.
I'm often asked, what is our charism? We are Benedictines. We are dedicated to Our Lady, and that's why we chose the name Sisters of the Blessed Virgin Mary. We actually wear a rosary, which is unusual for Benedictines. And what we've added to our rosary is actually a Benedictine crucifix. We're aggregated to the Subiaco Cassanese congregation. We're part of the English province. So we're part of a formal Benedictine family, and we live the full Benedictine life.
I'd like to share with you something of our monastic day, the Liturgy of the Hours, the means by which every part of the day is sanctified and given to God. The Psalms are the absolute bedrock of monastic spirituality. And using the Coverdale version of the Psalms enables us to have very deep reflection on the meaning of the Psalms. So we begin our day with vigils, or the office of readings, which is at 6 o'clock in the morning, and then we go away to pray or do whatever we need to do, and then we reassemble at 7 o'clock for Lourdes, which is the first of the daytime hours of the church. Then we assemble for Mass, usually at 9:30, and then we come together again at 12:30 for the midday office. Then in the late afternoon, we have Vespers, the evening prayer of the church, which is then followed about a couple of hours later by Compline, the night prayer of the church. And after that, we normally have about 15 minutes of adoration before the Blessed Sacrament, and then we go to bed, ready to start again at 6 o'clock in the next morning.
Hello. My name is Sister Patricia Ann Gordon. At the moment, I'm working in the kitchen, doing the menus and most of the cooking, feeding the community and any guests who come, or retreatants. Quite often, we get food given us by local parishioners. So we're very, very blessed in that way. But otherwise, they suffer what I prepare.
One of my responsibilities is looking after the guests, and we've realised over the years that what guests are seeking when they come to stay with a community like ours is an environment that's prayerful, quiet, where they can relax, where they can be cared for, where there's people to pray with, both as individuals and as a community, a comfortable bed and good food.
Being a nun is a way of life that I've grown into since when I was at school, really, because I was educated in a convent Catholic school. And from the day when I was 11 years old or 12 years old, I wanted to be a sister. And that's the thing I've wanted to do all my life, and which has been fulfilled.
Being a nun is for me a most radical option in life. I think that is a wonderful way of living out our baptismal calling, to give ourselves completely to God. And because we follow the rite of consecration, consecration in a biblical meaning means to be set aside for sacrifice. And so there's that sacrificial element, but also it's deeply spousal, as a member of Christ's body, to be fully united with Christ and to live that out in daily life. Yes, we all have our failures, and I have mine, but God is merciful, picks us up when we fall over and lets us walk again.
Being a nun is liberating, because you step outside. You step outside the structure. And I found I've been able to have friendships with people that I would not have been possible, and also wide-ranging friendships. We're dwelling the house of God. That's a beautiful thing, to live with people with the same focus. You haven't got that battle that so many Christians face in the wider world, in their families, in their workplace, wherever they're at school. We don't have that, and it's a great blessing.
We're due to move to Aston Hall in Stone, which we've got the opportunity of living in Aston Hall, surrounded by 6 acres of ground.
Aston Hall comes with a very special history. Those who are aware of the English history will know that there were periods when, being Catholic, you had to hide your Catholicism. Well, Aston Hall was where the relics of St. Chad were actually hidden. And it feels as if St. Chad has been part of that history. But he's not the only important person who's been connected with Aston Hall. Blessed Dominic Barbary, the priest who received St. John Henry Newman into the Catholic Church, he set up a Passionist novitiate there. So it feels that almost as if we've got all this special history of people who've lived there, who've prayed there, who've contributed to the spirituality of that place, and we're going to hopefully slot into that and become part of the next chapter of that special place. And it's a corporate work. We're all involved in making that prayerful atmosphere, in offering meals, hospitality, by spiritual accompaniment, or just being a praying presence.
I'm Monsignor Keith Newton, and I'm the ordinary of the personal ordinariate of Our Lady of Walsingham. I received a number of sisters from Wantage who were leaving their community to set up an institute of consecrated life within the Catholic Church and part of the Ordinariate of Our Lady of Walsingham. So it's a great joy to do that. But leaving their convent and looking for somewhere to live was a great act of faith and trust. So we're absolutely delighted now that with the help of the St. Barnabas Society, to purchase a house which has a great Catholic history. It's called Aston Hall. It'll be so much better for them because it will be a place of quiet and a place where people can go and have retreats and quiet days. So we're absolutely delighted that we have this community praying for us within the heart of the Ordinariate of Our Lady of Walsingham, which will also be a resource for people to go and spend some time in quiet.
May the divine assistance remain with us always and with our absent sisters. Amen.